body. Hope you're feeling fine.
Must I sing? I'm sorry. How are you people doing? My name is Sandra Adebayo, and this is Social Media Roundup, brought to you by Technest. With me in the studio, I have
Godfrey,
and I have Kini Kini. Guy, introduce yourself.
Did you like paparazzi.
That too much drama.
You're just being dramatic.
So mighty.
Really?
Yeah.
Give us the gist. Give us the gist.
We'll meet there. Anyway, hello everyone. This is another edition of the Social Media Roundup, provided to you by TechNext, and we have three stories for you. Although we had a lot of drama that happened through the week, but we have three big stories that we're bringing to you today, and one of them is the Oscar slap.
Wow.
In a couple of weeks ago, we had the inaugural slap.
It's a slapping season.
It's called Oscar slap.
You know, that was between two women. This was between
two older men.
Older men.
Mm. We need to put older there. Older men who should be role models. Anyway, Will Smith at the Oscars stood up from his seat, went to stage and slapped Chris Rock.
My God, for a joke. Just a joke.
Wait, no, don't say
it's not a joke. It's not just a joke.
It's a sensitive one. Bro, now sensitive joke.
Yeah, I agree though.
Anyway, yeah, some people said it was sensitive, and although some people said because Jada reacted, that's why Will Smith stood up.
Because he was laughing. Yes. She was laughing.
He was laughing.
Yeah.
Then when he saw the ladies containers, he was like, you don't talk to my wife like that.
Yeah. Anyway, they both apologized. Both Will Smith and Chris Rock have apologized. Chris Rock said it was insensitive and he has apologized for that. Will Smith said because he's a role model, he shouldn't have done that.
They're both wrong. They're both wrong, actually. But it depends on the way you look at it. We are not judging nobody. They can do better.
But wait, let's consider something. Just imagine if it was actually The Rock that was doing the MC.
It was the host,
The host of the show. Mm-hmm. Would Will Smith go over to the stage and slap him?
We never can tell.
Exactly.
People are bold. I remember one boxer that was so small. Is he a wrestler or I think he's a wrestler or a boxer. I don't remember now. Like beats everybody as small as he was. He's a popular name. I don't remember his name now. Talking about popularity, on Monday, a popular event happened and it broke our hearts.
Yeah.
A Kaduna-bound train was attacked by some people say bandits, but we all call them terrorists. As long as you are taking lives, you are a terrorist.
You are a terrorist.
And some people have been reported dead, some people are at the hospital, and some people were kidnapped. We should actually do a 10-second silence for the lives that were lost. So yes, as we said, some lives were lost, and one of them was Dr. Chinelo.
Wow, that was a sad one.
Yes.
It was a sad one because she actually tweeted about it before she died. You know, she was shot, and she put on WhatsApp, on Twitter, that she has been shot.
A lot of people
really cool the statement, you know, how can you be shot and you'll be tweeting at the same time? So I really don't get why people can be so insensitive to people's plight. As to, you know, you did not even show something that sympathy. Even try to investigate or call for help for such persons, and you're just criticizing their
Meanwhile, some people had already tweeted about the same train being attacked before she even tweeted. People had seen that there was a train attack. They should have connected the dots instead of attacking her.
Exactly. Just because of the savage replies. And I hope this becomes a lesson to a lot of people.
Just want to give savage replies on Twitter. And it's not even helping.
It's not helping the situations at all.
So our next story will be taken by Godfrey. He's already wearing a jersey.
This one is even more tiring because the whole intense, the bragging rights,
the Oyinbo boys.
Everybody,
I call them Oyinbo boys.
You know, everybody was all about the match between Ghana and Nigeria, and it ended in disappointment. I'm serious. You know, for me, I was shocked because the stars we had, the players we had, the people, like you call them,
Oyinbo boys.
They were all playing so well for their respective clubs.
Okay.
And they came over, we could not
and they can't
be,
give us that energy.
We're so excited that, okay, oh, because these people have been playing,
so well,
that they will come here.
We're going to win the game. Exactly. And you know about John Dumelo.
You know what? Do you know the sad thing about this guy is that we Nigerian actually made him. We have that bragging rights because we watch a lot of Nigerian.
Oh, shit.
Yes, now we watch Ghanaian movies. Let them know. We watch.
But you know, Ghanaians, they keep telling us they're better than us in everything apart from
music.
They're
not music. Even ready for. They were even dragged
it's
to the banter. Extent of jollof rice.
It's just banter.
The jollof rice issue.
The jollof rice.
I'm sure Ghana and Nigeria love themselves so much.
Serious, because it doesn't look
no,
like
I
that.
Think we do.
You know,
no, I
it's just
do.
Banter. You know, have you I noticed that do. When Ghana and Nigeria are bantering themselves? No other country can enter that conversation.
No other country.
You dare not.
We'll come for you.
Who are you, please? Where are you from? Why? Anyway, so John Melo said he's going to walk from Accra to Lagos. And
I was actually
asking to go and
buy.
You were looking
for
first.
Wow, I was actually looking.
He was not going to do that.
But you should know that's not possible.
He was not going to.
But imagine it was mentioned at what.
But you know, I think
no, he was not going to.
Actually, has he had seen something about that match? Because for him to come out and say something like that,
nothing.
No, everybody was just.
Everybody was just cruising.
Bragging rights,
you
know. Like we said, because we had Oyinbo boys, we were going to win. And, you know, and also the Ghana team have not been playing so well. So a lot of Nigerians thought that, okay.
Well, we're going to try.
I think that was what helped
again,
them
because we had
they
Oyinbo boys.
More because they know their boys have not been doing well. And, you know, when you know that you are competing with a higher version of yourself, you over prepare. So that's what happened.
We just hope that they go far.
And we're feeling ourselves.
I saw
like,
a tweet on Twitter. Was it today? Yeah, about the wishes of Nigerians having to have hoping to have Brazil, Argentina, Ghana, and Germany on the
please
same.
Please leave my country.
The World Cup. I was like,
we are going through too much in this country, so I do not blame our players. There's just so much.
Well, it may have
do.
Been that you know, kept them away from playing so well because they played like
yes,
they did not play like Nigerians. They were determined to win that match.
Well, it has ended. There was nothing we can do.
We're talking about it.
We're not going into the World Cup. Someone said, let's focus on more pressing issues in Nigeria. I think right now we have more pressing issues in Nigeria. You know,
we are always having
the security
pressing issues in Nigeria.
The security issue, you know, the kidnappings that's been ongoing, the education. So let's focus on those stuffs and, you know, give more priorities to them.
For me, we are always having pressing issues in Nigeria. That is real.
When Nigeria knows we get pressing issues. We're all pressers.
We are really trying. Yeah. We are really trying. And the way we still end up smiling at the end of the situation.
Suffering and smiling.
Irrespective,
exactly. So, thank you so much, viewers. Thank you for joining us on this episode. Thank you so much. And once again, this is not the only thing we do at TechNest. Rui? Sure.
Me? Okay. So at technext.ng, if you go to the website, we do news, analysis, reports, opinion pieces. Let me breathe.
And don't forget, this one is very important. It's very, very dear to my heart.
Why do I know what you want to say?
It's not easy because we are the biggest.
Abi.
We are the king in this game.
Abi.
Convener of the biggest crypto gatherings in Africa. Put some respect.
Coin Friends.
And we want you to anticipate for TechNext Coin Friends
2022.
It's going to be big. Sure. Thank you so much. Please join us next week once again. Thank you so much, Godfrey, for joining us this session.
Pleasure.
And really, no drama.
No drama.
Just say your name.
Everything.
I am.
Thank you guys.
The way you are saying it, like it's one.
Bye. They are not ready to leave this
studio. It's a powerful name.
Bye.